I don't think y'all are ready for this video. Truly. Grab your popcorn. Grab your wine. Grab your juice, your milk, whatever, honey. You gonna need it. Because we finna turn up. Okay? Track one.
We use the light from a flickering candle across the room to make the kind of shadows that only one thing could make. Love.
I like that. I like that one. I already know this one, but... yeah. I haven't listened to this song in such a long time. It's been like years. Slow down. Pick it up.
That's the way love goes.
Track three. It's called You Know. I think this is an interlude though. I don't know.
You know you want me.
The opera. The build up and then back to the court. Like, oh my God, nobody, they're not doing this like her. Not back then and not even now. You're done. Literally what she said at the end of the song. I was gagged. Miss Jenny be getting freaky, you hear me? Girl, you had me clutching my titties and shit. I ain't got none, but you had me clutching my goddamn shirt and titties and shit. Girl, I don't know what you, girl. Me literally having no idea that Mick Jagger wrote this fucking song. I don't think y'all get it. Mick Jagger wrote this song. Or co-wrote it, whatever. He was in on it. Do you know how fucking insane that is to say, hey, I have a song that was written by Mick Jagger, you know, lead singer of the Rolling Stones or whatever, you know.
By the way, I love this song because I've seen Poetic Justice only a million times, so.
Honestly, I see why it was nominated. You know, it should have won, in my honest opinion. But, you know, I enjoyed it. I'll always love this song. Not because of the movie, but just because of how it makes me feel on the inside. Because I think that's what matters the most. I keep thinking maybe it's funny how time flies, but I feel like that might be wrong. I think it's Come Back to Me. Yeah, Come Back to Me sounds a lot like Where Are You Now? Where Are You Now and Come Back to Me are like sisters or cousins. I feel like they're more sisters though. So that definitely gave that vibe. Wow, that track was very blissful. At the same time, like just soulful, like it made me feel like I was listening to Sade or, you know, something along those lines, you know, like, oh, that song was so good. Dear gosh. Like these are the, yes, girl.
I love a good skit. With my friend, not you. She's naming her friend. That is so cute. Like naming all her friends and she's like, come on y'all, this is so cute. How could you not love her? Like really, she said we on the beach. Yeah. Yeah, bitch. Ha. Just cool it. Oh, I know they was fucking this to the back. Lots of babies were made off this album. I'm more than quite sure. Oh, I love this bitch's mind. Oh my God.
This album, I think personally, is revolutionary. I don't think I've ever heard a piece of work like this, ever. I mean, it's Janet Jackson, so you really can't replicate, duplicate, none of that. You can't do none of that. But I'm just saying, as far as the music goes, sometimes you can hear certain songs and be like, oh, I know a song that kind of sounds like that. But with this album, you can't think of not one song other than her own being just like it. I feel like you can only compare Janet songs to Janet songs. You can't compare Janet songs to Michael, Aretha, Britney. You can't do none of that. She was in her own lane. Janet is by far one of the most sweetest, and I've never met her, obviously, but just based off of what I see, like, she's no different from her brother. I'm not going to say they're both perfect, but they're damn near close to it as people and as artists, because you can tell they just wanted to genuinely make the world happy by sharing music and film and whatever they did. So I appreciate Janet and I appreciate this album. Thank y'all for putting me on. Finally, just, bitch, listen to it. Listen to it. Mm-hmm. I have, and I ain't gonna lie, I'm finna listen to it again while I'm eating dinner. So that was all for today, guys. I mean, whew. That was a fucking album. How did it ever get so wrong?